genre.
Welcome back to Rocky Minute, a daily podcast where we analyze the movie Rocky 1 minute at a time. I'm Doug Greenberg.
And I'm Jason Haynes.
Joining us again, Armando Ronquillo from The Talented Slacker.
Hey!
Welcome back. How was your night? Good?
Doing great.
Today we're knocking out minute 68, which begins with Mickey saying he wants to take care of Rocky. And it ends with Mickey realizing it's over. Mm. Yeah, he says he doesn't want all the shit that happened to him happened to Rocky.
Right.
Is this the only curse that we see in the movie?
Oh, I found one that's not audible.
Me too. I think it's got to be the same one.
Yeah, is that
in this minute too? Yeah, that's in this minute. Yeah, we'll get to that.
Yeah.
So he says, you know, I care about you. I want to make sure the shit that happened to me doesn't happen to you. Sounds very sincere. I think he's really wants to help him. It may be, you know, it's also probably self-serving, obviously, but I think he does. If he's known for, what do we figure? He'd known him for 15 years ish. So I believe that he does want to help him. But this is the moment I was talking about yesterday where he finally stops beating on the bush and says, I want to be your manager. He hasn't said those words yet. He just keeps talking about manager, 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 manager. Mm-hmm. He said, you need a manager. Everyone needs a manager. But now he actually comes out and says, I want to be your manager.
Mm-hmm. And what does Rocky say to that?
He says the fight's set. He don't need a manager because the fight's already – that's what he thinks. Maybe Rocky thinks that's what a manager was supposed to do, just set the fight up. It's not a promoter. Right. It's a manager. So he just set up the fight and then that's it. But there's so much more.
And if you look at Rocky's face whenever he says the fight's set, I don't need no manager. He kind of has a little bit of a grin. Like, I know what you're doing here, man. Don't come at me, you know. Like, I'm just watching it right now, and it's just like, they're right there. It's like, yeah. I don't need, you know, the fight's set. And I always like that choice. You know, like, I've got you. I've got levity on you. Or I've got leverage on you. Like, what are you doing here? You know, I don't know. Yeah. I like that choice.
Yeah, that's like just like you said. It's like, why are you even bothering? Because fight's set. I don't need no manager. You're wasting your time.
Just wasted the last couple minutes, you know, with your sales pitch.
When Mickey says,
I want to make sure all this shit happened to me doesn't happen to you, there's emotion behind it. Mm-hmm. It's not like, I think up to that point, like, you know, when he's making his whole pitch, he's in there talking to himself, what he's been through. I didn't see a lot of emotion, you know, just kind of like, look, I've been through this, I've been through that, blah, 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 this and that. But this, he's like, I want, you know, he's starting to get emotional now, Mickey. He's starting to break down a little bit.
Before it was like he was trying a few different tactics to get Rocky to bite. Like he had a plan A, and then when that wasn't working, a plan B, which is starting to, like when he starts talking about Rocky Marciano and you remind me of the Rockies, kind of like using flattery to get to him.
I don't agree necessarily. It wasn't, we discussed this with, in the past episodes with Juergens, when Juergens was trying to sell Rocky in the fight. I believe Juergens had a plan A, plan B, like a good salesman, be like, all right, I'm going to start with this. If this doesn't work, I'm going to this. I don't think that's the case with Mickey. I think he just came in here and we knew that he knew that Rocky wasn't going to be 100% receptive to this, that because he had the long walk up the stairs. He didn't knock on the door right away. He was hesitant, you know, but I think he thought, you know, he could just come in here, open up, talk about his past, talk about the things he'd done. And then at some point, Rocky would just be like, all right, you know, yeah, you know, help me out or whatever. I didn't think that he thought he was not going to be receptive in the beginning, but I thought he would break him down eventually. But that's not working. And I think Mickey's legitimately starting to get emotional now to the point where, like, you know, when you're trying to convince somebody or something, you're talking, you're having an argument and it's not working out. At some point, you just break down and be like, all right, here's the reason, you know, and you just lay it all out there. I think Mickey's getting to that point. I don't think he had this all planned out. Because he didn't know the Rocky Marciano poster was there.
Right.
Never been in the apartment before. He hasn't been there 10 years. He's never been there. We know that.
He's been on his feet.
Improvising.
It's in his notes. Scan the room.
Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, I guess there's one, some sort of flattery to get you in this favor. You know, like, hey, you remind me of The Rock. And like, oh, yeah. Thanks. I do like The Rock. You know?
Well, he says in the script when he says that, let me go back. Talk amongst yourselves.
Here we go again.
What do we think of that sweater? Did you already talk about that sweater?
Yeah, but what's your opinion on it? Yeah,
you know what? I think I'd wear it just to show what kind of a fan I am.
That'd be a good cosplay.
Yeah,
I don't know. I think if you're gonna wear that, I think you need to go with. I don't think the black turtleneck works. You need to either find like a red turtleneck, the same color as the printing.
Right.
The red one, the black one, throws it off.
This is good fashion minute for Jake.
What is it? Rocky doesn't get fashion tips until part three, right?
Yes. Oh,
yeah. Well, he did wear the black jack. No, he wore it in this one too. I was like, in part two, he was a little bit more cleaned up. But three, oh my gosh, it's totally, totally different person. Like, he knows about Gucci and all that. Whereas this Rocky, he could give two craps of what Gucci is.
Mm-hmm. I probably found that sweater at the thrift shop. I was like, oh, 50 cents, I'll take it.
You have a turtleneck I can wear with it? We only have the black ones. All right. I'll have to do it. Doesn't really match, but I'll have to go with it.
Well, like, he even says it in Balboa, where he's looking at the dog and he's all like, that dog's got a lot of years in it. He's doing a whole lot by just sitting there. I think he had the same conversation with whoever he went with to buy this sweater. He's like, look, it's not doing much, but it's doing a whole lot. It's wanting you to buy it. I'll tell you, I see a whole lot. I read between the lines sometimes too much.
Then a minute-by-minute podcast would serve you very well.
About sweaters.
Yeah. But in reference to the Rocky Marciano, the comments comparing Rocky to Rocky Marciano, in the script it says, Mickey has rung the bell. Nothing could please Rocky more than being compared to his idol. Mm. So maybe at that moment he's starting to wear Rocky down a little bit. He just put his foot in his mouth between then and now. So
yeah,
Mickey says he's got the pain and the experience. And Rocky's hurt enough. Now he's going to lash out a little bit.
A said, little bit.
I've got pain. I got experience too. And Mickey tries to go on, but Rocky cuts him off. But even before that, when he says, when Rocky says the fight's set and Mickey says, I want to be your manager, he puts his hand on Rocky's shoulder and Rocky kind of just like shrugs it off and mm-hmm. he walks away.
Yeah.
Mickey's really trying to get to Rocky.
This I had here. This is the part I want to discuss what you already brought up with what from the script where, because I was going to say that, you know, Mickey, you know, has, they left that part of the script about him actually apologizing, but we already discussed that. So,
sorry about that.
Moving on. But I think we're at the point in discussion now where Rocky's had enough. You know, there's always that point in every argument, you know, it's not really an argument, back and forth, but there's always that point when someone's trying to tell you something that you don't want to hear or whatever, that where you've just had enough and you're just like, you know what? I had enough of your shit. And then he lets it out.
Oh, yeah.
He's been holding his back, though.
Yeah, this is going to start a few minutes of him just airing his grievances.
And this goes back to, this is why I wanted to bring up now and not before the apologizing, where Mickey never actually apologizes. Because now, even when he says, Rocky, Mickey says, I got pain experience. Rocky's like, yeah, I got pain experience too. Now Rocky goes, I needed your help 10 years ago, right? And Mickey goes, well, if you wanted my help, why didn't you just ask? And then he says it again, where he goes, if you wanted my help, just ask. So, like, even that, like, Mickey's not apologizing for the fact that he hasn't helped Rocky for the past 10 years. He's deflecting it back onto Rocky. Like, Rocky saying, you know, I need your help 10 years ago. Where were you, basically? And Mickey's like, well, if you wanted my help, why don't you just ask me? This is a perfect opportunity for him to go, yeah, I'm sorry for that. You know, I didn't pay attention to you. I didn't help you out. I let you slide by I let you go by the wayside. I'm sorry. Like that. But he doesn't. He deflects it and blames it, puts the blame back on Rocky again.
It's like a thing somebody does when their back's against the wall. You kind of flip it on the person that's accusing you.
Right.
I've done that.
I did it yesterday, you know. It sounds something like, if you want me to help you do the dishes, why don't you ask for help doing the dishes?
We're not mind readers.
Yeah, man. Like, you looked happy doing them. I didn't know you wanted me to interfere with your happiness. You want to help? Just say, hey, Zay, can you help me do the dishes? Right?
He says, look, I came to you 10 minutes ago and asked you to help me do the dishes.
you wanted help? Yeah, you should ask for help. I mean, I thought you were working out when you were carrying that laundry basket up and down the stairs. I thought you wanted help.
Exactly. And if you do help, you're like, oh, hey, I can do this by myself. I don't need no man to help me. You got it. I've heard that before.
We all have. Oh, man. But Rocky retreats into the bathroom and shuts the door. Mm. So, Mickey.
Gosh, what if you started hearing some sound effects? Like, he just wanted me to take a, you know what, a big old...
We do hear a toilet flush. nice little break in the tension.
Did he wash his hands? Do we hear a...
Nope. We did not hear a sink. We hear a toilet flush, no water running.
I guess
no
that kind of goes into what happens later on when they're outside the apartment.
Oh, man.
I think Mickey remembered.
That's why he's trying to run away from him.
All right, slow down.
Yeah, we'll get to that in just a second. But, yeah, what if, like, you know, he went in there and Rocky was just like, man, he was trying to relieve himself. Like, oh, my gosh, I really got to take this shit. This guy keeps talking, you know. That's why he keeps saying, hey, the fight's set, man. It's over.
Yeah, he's trying to rush him out so he could go take a crap. But it's like, you know, when somebody's talking to you, you can't really fully let yourself go. Mm-hmm. You know? You need peace and silence.
But Rocky does say something though. He says that he did it. He says, "I asked you. You ain't heard nothing." Mm-hmm. So that he's saying that he has been asking for help, and Mickey couldn't be bothered with him. So that's what's leading to another factor in Rocky's why he's so bitter right now is because he's saying, like, listen, I've been asking you for help and you haven't done shit for me, and now here I get this big shot and here you are at my house for the first time in 10 years to get here.
10 years.
So yeah, but well, yeah,
like, does a lot of it have to do with, I mean, I know he says you became a cheap leg breaker for a loan shark. I mean, I wonder, does he have history with the oh my gosh, I can't even think of his name, Gazzo. Do you think Mickey has history with Gazzo also?
There was probably a time if Rocky's known and Mickey have known each other since Rocky was 15. I'm sure he wasn't working for Gazzo at 15. Mm-hmm. So there was probably a time Rocky was fighting, wasn't putting the work in, wasn't into it, and then got hooked up with Gazzo, and then Mickey, like, this is a classic story. Like, you're watching him go down the wrong path, hang out with the wrong people. He watched him go off with Gazzo, and he probably in the beginning tried to bring him back in, but Rocky was probably making money, more money than he's making fighting, so he didn't want to hear it, so he went off with Gazzo. And then Mickey was just, maybe Mickey was hurt, and then Mickey just let him go. Mm. And then at some point, Rocky came back around again and wanted his help, and Mickey was probably like, well, why don't you go get help from the two-bit loan shark? It's probably a whole history. This has got to be a prequel.
Yeah. Do a Yip Man type of movie with Mickey. And I don't know if y'all seen that movie, but like Bruce Lee shows up at the end of that, of one of them. And in Mickey's story, Rocky shows up at the end with Gazzo and stuff. I don't know.
I'd watch it.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
There's definitely room for a prequel to Rocky. That's our idea. Anybody tries to steal it. I'll be paying attention.
Mickey's energy is all gone here.
Well, this is just it. This is just when you just break down. I've tried everything. The guy's not budging. Mm-hmm. He closes the door. He's in the bathroom doing whatever he's doing in there.
And his Mickey's.
And then everything just comes out. Pain, frustration, hopelessness, all the. But
Mickey goes into like a little woe is me kind of like, I'm 76 years old. It's right now with that. I'm 76 years old. It's like, that's it. My
this is it.
Is gone. Mm-hmm. It's all done.
Yep. There's a lot of pain here in Mickey's I'm 76 years old.
Yeah, a whole lot. And then that's when he turns and what is this feel? I do want to say this part right here, this whole little scene feels like a stage play. Like I feel like I'm watching this on a stage or something like that, and it feels like this is acting 101 sort of thing, Like, mm-hmm. This is where you learn acting from. I don't know. Yeah. It's like, compared to today, where you watch Vin Diesel or The Rock, doing their thing, it's so much. I mean, you can tell, you can tell the difference between the two, but it's just like this right here is where you're watching real acting. And Burgess Meredith, God rest his soul. I think y'all said it, this is the best role that he's ever done. I don't know. I got to give my hats off to that part where he says, I'm 76 years old. And it's just like, man, he does say a whole lot with that line.
Yeah, you can see it.
But yeah, it's just his emotional. His head's on the door. He's just he's losing his breath. He wants to start crying right now. Uh-huh. Yeah, you see a lot of emotion. This is 50 plus years of being in the game and not getting anything out of it. And this is your shot, and it's slipping through your fingers. And he made that last ditch effort to try and get it, win him over, and you couldn't. He still doesn't say I'm sorry though. I don't hear the word sorry.
Well, let me go back to the script for a minute.
Oh, but I want to say one thing. You said this is Burgess Meredith's best role. Hello, Penguin.
Oh, yeah, Penguin. Yeah, he did have that role. I forgot about that. And wasn't he in Grumpy Old Men as well?
Was he?
I don't know. I think he was.
I remember seeing him in that one.
I don't know. We'll have to go check it out. Everybody, email us or check in on the listeners page if he's in Grumpy Old Men. Well, let us know.
So go ahead. You're looking up the script again.
So Mickey says the part about I got pain and experience. Rocky says I got pain and experience too. Mickey says, please, kid. Mm. He never says please in the movie, in the script. There's a please in there.
Now, is that a sarcastic, like, please, you don't know pain and experience. I have pain and experience. Or is that like, please let me train and be your manager, kid?
I think it's him asking. I don't know. At this point, I don't think it would serve him to knock Rocky down with a please pain and experience.
Yeah, I'm with you there.
Mickey drops an ashtray and kneels to pick it up. He remains on one knee. If you wanted my help, why didn't you just ask? And Rocky says, I asked you, but you never helped nothing. Like the Bible says, you don't get a second chance. Throwing his own thing right back into Mickey's face. Mm-hmm. And then he says, Rocky, I'm 76 years old. Maybe you can be the winner I never was. Your shot is my last shot. Mm-hmm. So he's coming straight out and saying more in the script than he actually did in the movie.
Because I don't think he had to say all that. We got all that.
Yeah, right. I agree. The directorial choices were definitely better than what was written.
Right. It's great acting, though. I feel Mickey's pain. If I was a boxer, I'd call him up right now and hire him as my manager.
So, yeah. Armando, when he turns to leave, what do you notice? What does he mouth?
He says, oh, fuck.
He mouths the words, oh, fuck.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Did you notice that before? Because I didn't notice it until I was just researching the minutes for this.
I noticed it a couple of times. I noticed that Rocky never curses and everything. And, you know, like, I noticed I was watching this, like, recently, and I was like, oh, my gosh. I was like, he just said the F word.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Not a whole lot of F words in the Rocky series.
What does he say the second time?
What?
He mounts something else after he says that.
I'm 76 years old again, maybe?
No. I thought he said, where'd I park my truck? But whatever. Mickey doesn't have a truck.
What kind of truck do you think he drives?
I don't know.
What is he parking around the block? He walks a long way after this.
But he says here, right? Now watch him. He mounts something else. Right at the end of the minute, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not audible. We'll never know.
Yeah. You know, Armando, there should have been another one that was written in the script but never made it to the movie with Little Marie. Instead of screw you, creepo.
She
drops the hammer.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was, I think, I would think that screw you, creep. Well, probably because I've heard it, you know, in these movies. I want to say screw you, creepo sounds better. But, I mean, can you imagine hearing it the other way around? Like, oh, God, that's, like, this person's got a lot of hostility.
Yeah. You know,
whereas screw you, she holds back and says screw you instead. Or it's like, well, maybe there could be hope for this person instead of saying the actual word. You know, I don't know. That's just me wondering about that Little Marie character. Because if I was Rocky and someone said the F you to me, you know, like F you creepo, I'm like, you know what? F you right back.
Yeah.
Whereas screw you, it's just like, you know, she didn't go all the way.
You can recover from screw you.
Exactly.
The F you is a little
I've, hard to... I've had both yelled at me before, and they both hurt just as much as the same. It won't hurt.
Sticks and stones. Stick.
Words hurt.
My 5-year-old.
Words hurt.
So at this point, Rocky would rather go into this fight alone instead of, you know, with a guy that's just trying to piggyback on his newfound fame. The scene here, it was written to end right here.
But it didn't. Or does it? We don't know.
In the script, Rocky... You know, he goes and sits on the bed after Mickey leaves, and then after a few moments of thought, then we'll get to what he does next. But there was no him airing out all this pent-up aggression and stuff that he's been holding on for years and years.
Mm.
So another good directorial choice.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
All right.
See you in that.
Tell us and the fans where they can find Talented Slackers?
You can find us on Twitter at Talented Slacker, and you can find me on Twitter as well at ManBet33, where we talk about nothing but movies and stuff. So it's you know, check us out.
Mm-hmm. You guys have a website, or you just do the iTunes?
We just do the iTunes. You know, we were gonna do the website, but I was just like, oh, that's too much work.
Yeah, that's why we, speaking of Mickey piggybacking, we piggybacked on our friend's Scott Corelli's website, duelinggenre.com. So That's where he does all the heavy lifting. We just post the episodes there.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, that's basically all I do. All we do is just post the episodes, talk movies, post the episodes, and bam, hope you guys like it.
Yeah, pretty simple formula, you know?
Yeah.
We are Rocky Minute on Twitter. We have a Facebook listeners page, Mighty Mix. It's a closed group, so you click the join button and we'll make sure you get approved and join the discussion over there. As I mentioned before, we're on duelinggenre.com, and our episodes are on iTunes and Google Play and pretty much anywhere you can find a podcast. All right, so Mickey's about to walk out, and we've got to check back in to see what happens on the next Rocky Minute.